This video is all about tables. Why should we have them? What are the benefits and how exactly to use them? Try this out and the way you work on Excel will change for better forever. Let's start with a simple two column data. I have some formulas, chart and pivot table based on the data. When I add more data, nothing changes. I have to go to each formula, each range and manually update it. That's the job of tables. So as soon as you put data, go to insert, create table, remember Ctrl T. It checks, do you have headers? Yes. Now, when I add more data, all formulas and charts or dependents will get updated. Pivot table did not. Pivot table does not get refreshed unless you right click and refresh. I'm going to copy paste data now. As long as you paste it right next to the table, it will automatically expand and update everything. What if my data has gaps? No problem. It's smart enough to figure it out. I have a formula depending on that data on another sheet. When I add more data here, all formulas across sheets which depend on the data will be updated. Here is another scenario. I have a lot of data and I want to put a calculated column. The formula is simple, 3% of the amount. How do I copy the formula? Either I drag it and take a long time to do it, wasting my time, or I double click, but then I have a risk because if there is a gap, that formula is going to stop there. So don't do either of them. First, create a table. Go to the beginning, try to find the end point of the table. Ctrl End may or may not work, but somehow you have to find the range of the table. Once you are sure that you have selected the correct range, create the table. I'm going to press F2 to edit the formula. And now just press Enter. Not only did it copy the formula, it has actually not bothered about the empty cells. The formula continues and it has reached to the bottom. Every time you add a calculated column, you never have to check whether it reached the bottom. That means accuracy. And of course, you don't waste time dragging and double clicking. So time saving as well. When your cursor is in the table, you can see table design menu. When you click on it, you will notice there is a name given to the table. This name is given automatically, but it's a good idea that we should give more legible names. So I'm going to call this table Receipts. Right click on the table name and say Add to Quick Access Toolbar. Now you can see and edit the name of any table right from here. Very convenient. Another important thing. Here I wanted to calculate the total tax payment. So I put a simple formula, sum of C colon C. That generally is a bad idea because here, if someone puts some unrelated data in column C below, you're going to be paying more tax. We do it because it's convenient to put it like this. But now we have an even better method of doing it, which is accurate and convenient. So let's put a better formula now. Sum. I know the name of the table, Receipts. Press Tab. Open square bracket. It'll give you a list of columns, even if this was on another sheet. I want to choose the tax column. Again, press Tab, complete the square bracket, complete the round bracket or parenthesis, press Enter. Now let's see what happens when I go and add some data in column C, which is unrelated to the receipts table. This C colon C formula doesn't understand anything and it will force me to pay more tax than I actually need to pay. Whereas the table-based formula will always give you accurate results. Like formulas, formatting also gets automatically managed using tables. I have applied conditional formatting here. I'm showing the top one means the highest value and the range is D5 to D8. When I add more data outside the table but touching the table will expand. The conditional formatting range will also expand and I will still see the highest value as expected. So D8 has automatically changed to D10 and the conditional formatting works as expected. Similar thing happens with validation as well. I have applied validation, which restricts the value between 10 and 30. If I add something more than 30, it is not going to accept it. And you'll notice that the table did expand. When I add the valid value, it's going to accept it. Right now, there is no validation applied to this data. Retrospectively, I'm going to apply validation. Same validation, value between 10 and 30. You'll notice that there is a green mark or error checking mark, which not only tells me that there is a problem, but it also displays type information. So this helps us identify the values which are invalid and also the reason why they're invalid. Another use of table is for list validations. For example, I want to have a drop down here showing Word, Excel, PowerPoint. I'm going to apply list type of validations, and as source, I will use these three rows. The drop down will work as expected, but when I add one more item in the base list, it's not going to work. For it to work, select the data, Ctrl T to create a table. Remember, this table does not have a header. That's okay. It's going to add something called column one. And now when I add more items, the list does expand as expected. Ideally, this itself should be a table. Now notice that Excel did not detect that the table does have a header. So you have to be careful and tell Excel, yes, whatever we have in the first row is indeed the header. And now it will create the table properly. And finally, when I add more rows, the list validation will carry forward as expected. Tables simplify use of COUNTIF and similar functions. Usually, we have to put the whole range, put dollar sign to freeze the range, and then copy the formula. When I add more data, the formula does not change. I have to edit the formula, manually change the range, and copy it all over again. This is very cumbersome. With tables, it becomes extremely simple. I don't have to select the column at all. Just open the square bracket, choose the column name, complete the square bracket. The second parameter also has to come from the category column, but this time I only want to pick it up from the current row. So at the rate, which is this row, then select category, complete the square bracket, complete the round bracket, and we are done. The best part is when I add more data, I don't have to change anything in any of the formulas. It just works. Tables will also simplify your VLOOKUP and HLOOKUP usage. This is a table. The lookup table itself is a table. The name of this table is rates. The VLOOKUP formula is simple now. At the rate means current row. Second parameter is the table array. And in this case, we already have a table name. Even if this table was a large table and in another sheet, exactly the same syntax will work. Only thing you need to know is the name of the table before you start typing the formula. I want data from second column. And of course, this is not a range lookup. Now India is missing. When I add more data, I don't have to change the formula. It will just work. In many cases, the lookup table has duplicate rows. And when you are adding a new row at the bottom, you don't realize that it's a duplicate row. We can now solve that problem quite easily. So I have put a COUNTIF column. Even if I can't see the entire table and I'm just adding one more row at the bottom, if I see number two, that means it's a duplicate entry. So I'm preventing mistakes and increasing accuracy. Now let's see how to create a table properly. This is a very simple table. I can see the entire data, so I don't have to select it. Ctrl T will select it automatically. Click OK, table done, give it a name, and that's it. But when the data is long, this may or may not work exactly as expected. Because if there are blank cells, subtotals, totals, you have to explicitly select the range and then create the table. That is safer. In this case, I have put some formatting to make the table look good. When I create the table formatting does not get applied. Even if I go to the table menu and try to change the formatting, nothing happens because this formatting has been manually applied. So table doesn't override it. No worries. Right click and say apply and clear formatting. And now we have everything as expected. This is a particularly dangerous situation where in the original data, you have put some formatting, but that formatting has a business meaning. If I create a table and override the formatting, I'm losing the meaning as well. So very important, understand what the meaning is, put a column, add that data, and now you can create table and clear the formatting without losing any business information. One common mistake all of us have done is, let's say I want to change the formatting in this column. So I'm going to select the whole column and then apply the formatting. This is a really bad idea because this is not just applied to the table, it's applied all the way wherever the last row is. And that is a big problem because this increases file size. So how do you solve the problem? Well, just by observing the mouse cursor. This is the column selection cursor. Bring it down, cell selection. Continue to bring it down, you will see column selection cursor again. And now, when you apply any formatting, notice what it is going to do. It has only applied it to the table data and not wasted formatting quota. Selecting data also becomes simpler with tables. If I am inside a table and press Ctrl A, it will select only the data area. Next Ctrl A will select the header, and third Ctrl A will select the sheet. On the other hand, if my cursor was inside the header, first Ctrl A will select the whole table and second Ctrl A will select the whole sheet. Often our Excel files become complicated and moving from one place to another becomes a problem. Now I want to go to a table, but I know the name of the table. You go to this box, it is called name box. There's a drop down, open that and go to the name of the table directly. So the table name is also a quick way of navigating from one place to another. Brilliant. Here is another common problem. Notice I have clicked outside, and when I scroll down, I can just see ABCD. I cannot see the column names. Click inside, and that ABCD is replaced with the column name. Click outside, it's ABCD. Click inside is the correct column name. So now you don't have to freeze pane at all. Another brilliant feature of tables is called structured formulas. For example, I want to add a calculated column, which is amount minus tax. Of course, I will add it towards the end. Why did I add it here? Because next month when more data comes, I can simply copy paste without any column mismatch. Never mind. Now at this stage, I don't want to press left arrow trying to find where is the amount column. Press square bracket. Yes, we want this row, amount, tab, close the bracket, and then repeat the process. And of course, this is a table, so it's going to auto copy the formula anyway. Now let's look at another brilliant feature which comes with tables. It's called slicers. Go to table design, insert slicer. You can choose one or more of the items here. And now these filters will float like this. You can rearrange them in such a way that they don't overlap with each other. And now, instead of using the traditional auto filter, I can see exactly what is getting filtered. I can do multi-select and many more. I have a detailed video on slicers. Have a look at that as well. Often, we need to import data from other Excel files and clean them up using Power Query. When I go to Data, Get Data from File, Excel, and choose that file, it will show me the sheets as well as the table. Look at the sheet. It is showing me the same data which we saw just now, but it is giving me all kinds of unwanted stuff. Whereas when I click on the table, it's all clean data. Always import tables, never import sheets. Do you create macros? Even there, tables are useful. Why? Because often when you're writing a macro in VBA, you need to find out how many rows the data has, how many columns it has. And usually people go in a loop and look for some empty row. That's a misleading, time-consuming, and error-prone method. Now, when you go to VBA, all tables are available as an object. So you can simply go and iterate the rows or columns collection. The only thing to remember is the object name is not table. It's called list object. I've given the link in the description. So what is the best practice? As soon as you have data, put it in a table. More efficient and less error prone. I'm absolutely sure you found this useful. So please share it with as many people as you can. Let everyone become more efficient. And before you go, I would like you to look at this video, which tells you exactly what clean data means. And that will make your data cleanup as well as analytics much more efficient and faster. So that's it for now. Thank you.